Hi lovers, welcome back. Coach Kara here. So today I want to talk about moving in together with your partner. Now if you're watching this video, perhaps you have been contemplating that, or maybe you have already begun to live with your special person. So today's video is basically going to be about me just giving you the necessary behaviors and actions that actually needs to take place in order for you to have a functioning and stable household. Okay? All right, so we all know as humans, just being with someone in a relationship can be quite challenging. Well, living together and deciding to reside with one another could possibly be that as well. So to simplify things for you, let me just give you some of the necessary actions that need to take place, like consistently. Firstly, before you move in with your person, how well do you know them? Have you guys known each other longer than 2 years? Do you really know them in depth as much as you could know anybody? You know, you're not gonna know someone completely, you know, 100%. But do you really know them on a deeper level? How is your connection? Are you guys respectful to each other? Do you understand each other? Because where there's a lack of understanding outside of being in a household, you're going to create more problems for yourself. So the one thing that you definitely want to have down packed is understanding and mutual respect. Make sure your person respects themselves as well as you, and vice versa, okay? That definitely has to be a necessity in your connection. Next, is your connection stable? And what I mean by that is, of course, you're gonna have your disagreements and, you know, whatever, but how stable is it? Do you guys interact the way you should? You know, is your communication the way it needs to be? Do you guys have good conflict resolution? Meaning you don't just sit and fight over small things, you rectify the matter as quickly as possible, even if it is something that is, you know, quite grand, you know how to resolve, right? So these are key things. And the reason why that is because many people think they can live together and everything is going to be lovely and like a fairy tale. Well, fairy tales, we all know, are more than likely most are fiction. So when you reside together, things can happen. If someone has a temper, they don't know how to control their anger, they lack self-control, self-discipline, okay, before you know it, who's gonna come knocking? So you wanna make certain that you two are able to be in a situation, a connection that is grounded in being emotionally stable with each other, like you know how to resolve. That means both of you basically needs to be mature, all right? So there has to be a higher sense of mature, a higher level of maturity there as far as being able to resolve conflicts. Yeah, all right. And moving on to the other important factors that goes into moving in with one another, are you both financially stable? What you really want to consider, because life happens, you know, someone may lose their job, but do they have a position or a career that allows them to move right on? Like say your person is an IT person, technician, or, you know, they're in some sort of office position, or maybe a nurse, something that can easily allow them to transition to another job. Are they in that type of position? Because if they're not, it can become quite challenging. I've seen it all too many times, okay? You definitely want to make sure both of you are financially stable, not for the mere fact of just being able to pay the monthly bills, but what if something happens? What if one of you become ill for 2 weeks? You know, granted, you only have a certain many hours of sick time, but are you going to be able to maintain the household? You know, you really can't control the inevitable, or when life decides to just want to life all over you and your world. Are you guys going to be able to support each other, not just emotionally, but financially as well? because we all know what the end result is if you don't. Yeah? So that's definitely something you really want to keep in mind. Next, how responsible are the both of you? Are you responsible with your money? You know when to spend and when to be a bit frugal because you know the bills are coming around. Is your person equally as responsible? These are things that you really want to take into consideration. Seriously, people, you really do. Are they really responsible? That means being able to clean up after themselves, you know, which brings me to the next. Do you guys have similar living habits? Have you stayed the night with them and vice versa? Are they as clean as you are? Are they, you know, reliable? Can you depend on them to be able to turn off the stove when you leave the house? That sort of thing. So all of these things goes into factor. You definitely, especially when it comes to cleanliness, you know, I was quite fortunate with my last situation. You know, everything, both of us were clean freaks. We never have to worry about that, and quite responsible because we definitely wanted to always keep the utility on. You know, it was just one of those things. So worked out for me, but for many other people, it doesn't. What typically happens is you end up arguing because someone decided to not pick up after themselves. There's clothes lying around. Someone's leaving toothpaste in the sink and not cleaning it up. And so those fights, they turn into bigger issues because now you're having an issue that you don't have to clean up after your person, and it just morphs into bigger concerns, yeah? Next, this is a big one. Do either of you have children? If not, beautiful, that's great. However, many people do, at least one child. Is your person going to be willing to take on some of that responsibility of having to pick a child up for school, be present for, you know, birthdays, that sort of thing? And the bigger priority is being able to have some kind of rapport with the other parent. You know, at some point they will have to meet that parent if you guys haven't already. But if they have and they're good, beautiful. You know, having the parent to drop the kid off, you will have to interact at some point and have some sort of discussion. So you will be included in that. Are you able to handle that ex coming around? Okay? Which makes me also want to bring into the equation about jealousy. Now, if you or your person has jealousy issues, you really want to consider moving in with them, because if you already have an eagle eye on your person or vice versa, that can actually heighten, you know, it may enhance their insecurities, which is why I said you want to be as stable as you possibly can. So if you are a bit insecure with your person and you have jealousy issues, Just think more into this situation, because you may not be snooping through the phones and following them and checking up on them right now, but just because you're there, you're present, and you're able to watch their habits, what they're doing, their ins and outs, their time, you know, you're going to probably want to know everything. And that is something you really want to just keep in mind if you really are ready to cohabitate. Next and lastly, friends. Are your friends decent enough to be around your person, to come over? Are they respectful? Are they flirtatious? Are they just a bit rambunctious? You know, the type of friends that come over, you know, they'll lay on your bed or sit on your sofa and put their feet up. They just kind of like take over, you know, smoke weed, drink, just make it their own. Are they that type of friend? If so, you should probably have a discussion with them, as should your person. So there's going to have to be certain levels of boundaries and respect when it comes to people from the outside. Hell, even family members. You may have, you know, issues with, they just think they can come over anytime and just kind of be intrusive on your privacy. So yeah, that's pretty much the gist of residing with someone. Look, guys, it's not something that you should take lightly, because it is a big responsibility, especially if you're not intending to marry, there isn't an engagement, or You don't really see one in the foreseeable future, the foreseeable near future. Okay, you should probably already been in a discussion of that anyways, all right? But if you are thinking about residing with your person, these are just some of the main factors or you know, that should be focused highly upon so that you can take deep consideration before you make that move, literally and figuratively. Okay, all right, my love. Hopefully this has been helpful for you. I thank you guys for joining me always. All of my information will be linked down below. That is all for now. Until next time.